Amanda, do you want
no.
more? Do you want cards?
No,
thank you. No cards? Do you want
no,
a 5 minute?
Just at the 5, yeah.
5? Okay.
Oh, I'm not okay. Maybe I shouldn't say yell. I'm going to be speaking to the Ross. I'm not going to be looking at any of
my emotions.
Sorry, is that your bad car, Riley?
I'm going to be speaking to Rob.
I was paying off my daughter, and I didn't care.
Oh. So I'll give you the. I just took it from the website because they can explain it a lot. It's very confusing. So this speech is entitled, I Knew I Had to Do Something to Set Myself Apart. It's from the movie Down with Love. I don't know. I know where else has seen it. It's set in 1962 in NYC. It's about Barbara Novak, the female empowerment book author of Down with Love. And she gives a long, convoluted explanation to Lothario Playboy, Petra Block, who was a star reporter for No Magazine. She tells him about her long quest to grab his attention. Meanwhile, Block has created a false alias as NASA astronaut Major Zip Martin in order to expose her hypocrisy, to humiliate her, and to seduce her. He's even had her followed by a private ad.
I love that you have him sitting there, and that's hilarious.
I just mean,
okay.
And in the movie, like, they just focus on her, so I told him to look confused, but I don't know what he does in the movie.
We're not judging you on Rob's act.
No. He's like, do you want me to say stuff? I was like, no, I just want you to say it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
You ready? I'm not going to storm out of you. And I'm not going to admit that you got Barbara Novak to fall in love. Because I'm not Barbara Novak. There is no Barbara Novak. And I didn't fall in love with Zip Martin. No, I fell in love with Ketcher Block. And that was a year ago, when for 3.5 weeks, I worked as your secretary. I don't expect you to remember me. I wasn't a mom then. But you did ask me out, and it broke my heart to say no. But I loved you too. I couldn't bear to become just another notch in your bedpost. With your dating habits, I knew that even if I was lucky enough to get a spot on your rotating schedule, I would never have your attention long enough to get you to fall in love with me. I knew I had to do something to set myself apart. I knew I had to quit my job as your secretary at No Magazine, write an international bestseller, get the eye of a New York publisher as well as your magazine, but insignificant enough that as long as I went unseen, No Magazine star journalist would refuse to do a cover story about it. I knew that every time we were supposed to meet up, you'd stand me up by one of your many girlfriends. And that would give me a reason to fight with you over the phone and declare that I wouldn't meet with you for 100 years. And then, all I would have to do was wait and be patient, just the 2 or 3 weeks that I would need to get the publicity for you to, one, see who I really was, and two, see me denounce you in public as the worst. But saying I love you was also part of my plan. I just wanted to tell you the truth so when you heard me say I love you, you would know that I know who you were, and you would know who I was. Then you, the great Ketcher Block, would know that you've been beaten at your own game by me, Nancy Brown, your former secretary. And I would have once and for all set myself apart from all the other girls that you've known, from all the other girls that you never really cared by making myself someone like the one person you really love and admire above all others, you. I knew that this would make you want to get even by writing one of your exposés. And in order for you to do that, you'd have to go undercover, assume a false identity, and pretend to be the type of man that would make the girl I was pretending to be fall in love. And I knew that since I was pretending to be a girl that would have sex with you on the first date, you would have to pretend to be the type of guy that wouldn't have sex for several weeks. And in doing so, we would go out on lots of dates to all the best places and all the hit shows, until finally, one night, you take me back to your place, the place that you're pretending was someone else's, in order to seduce me until I said I love you. Then, when you realized that you had finally met your match, I would have at last gained the respect I needed to make you want to marry me first and seduce me later. I just wanted you to hear all this from me before you heard it from your private eye. And now you know everything. So tell me the one thing I don't know. Tell me if it's made you fall in love with me as I love you.